on, so I'm going to just show you how to set the our custom Photoshop settings from week number one, and we will be able to use the settings that I give you. Okay, so from week one you have these two folders, and under Photoshop settings for students, you go inside and you see the presets here. Okay, for presets there will be three folders inside, just good for you to know. Okay, we are changing the keyboard shortcuts, we are changing the brushes, and then there is also actions here that is also put in there, but maybe we will go to it later. So for now, just need to know that you are changing all this for our local Photoshop settings. Okay, so we have this over here, and then now we need to find the local Photoshop settings. So how do we do that? Okay, we go to Photoshop. Okay, I'm just gonna set my workspace back to default again. So okay, so this is default Photoshop. And first thing you gotta do, we go to brush. I can press F5 to get it out, and you have all these default brush settings here. I'm just gonna grab brush settings, grab the tab, and then we drag it to the left. And open this up so we get all the brushes. And we are gonna, from here, we will try to look at the brush directory by just clicking on replace brushes. Okay, later we are going to just close it, but for now you can just use here. So when you press replace brushes, it will load up to the local presets. So this is all your local settings, and then you just go into all these folders here that is hidden in your directory, and you'll see that most important one is Adobe Photoshop CC, and you go to our preset brushes. Okay, so we will be replacing mainly presets here. Okay, so we will grab this whole string, copy, go to our two Windows Explorer side by side. Okay, that's the most useful way to just change settings. Very easy to change if you have quite a big monitor. Then we'll just tap it back upwards so that we can jump up to presets here. Okay, so now that we are in both the presets folder, we will change these three folders. Three folders into these three folders. So it's pretty straightforward. We just want to copy it directly into these three folders. And what we're going to do is we want to make sure that you don't mess it up by copying it into another directory within the folder. So one common mistake is that you might be able to put all the folders in and you think you do it correctly, but actually all your folders end up in one of these folders. So it's something like this, all the folders inside this folder here. So that is not correct. Okay, it's supposed to be outside and just going right into these three folders. So what we can do, we can just go to maybe small icons. Okay, because why? We want to make sure we have a empty space over here. Okay, empty space, easy for us to do right click and paste. So we want to make sure we have some empty space. Copy all these three folders, copy, empty space, paste. Say yes, replace everything, you know what you're doing, and you just pop it in like this. So it's telling you that it's putting into all these three folders correctly. So if you got this part wrong, please rewind the video, go back and watch it again. So you see, all the folders will have our settings in there. One settings each. Okay, pretty cool. So now if you go to Photoshop, you see that when we load, you know directly that I can load this up. Okay, so why not? I can just do that right now. And it's done. Okay, so this is all my custom brush settings. and it's being loaded up and replaced already, because just now we use replace to replace the brushes. Okay, so this is become your custom Photoshop brushes, and it's quite handy, and you can also load up your own brushes if you want. Okay, so next up we will do our keyboard shortcuts. Okay, so okay, not this one now. So yes, and you should be in Photoshop defaults anyway. And sorry, what did I press just now? You should be in Photoshop defaults anyway. That was just my own setting just now. And so when we right now, Photoshop isn't able to get this settings here because it needs to reload Photoshop. So why not we do that? So basically, there's three parts. Okay, we want to get our brushes down. We want to get our shortcuts down, and then we want to get our workspace down. Okay. So brushes is done. Next is the keyboard shortcuts and the preference settings, and we are going to do it so that we can use dodge, burn, all this easily in our using our custom shortcuts that I set. Okay, so if you do it correctly, you will see this Alfred student keyboard shortcuts that I have set for you on this date, and when you click on that, it will ask you. Okay, it will result a loss of okay, nope, and I'm good. Okay, so I'll just have this shortcut anyway, because that pop-up was because I was using another shortcut on my computer, but I purposely deleted it so that everyone can use this shortcut as the default shortcut. And so when you just switch it, there's actually no pop-ups at all. Okay, so you just have the keyboard shortcut and everything is set for you. So how do you know? We will just check it out. So we have Control N, new document, go to print, A4 print, and then start by using, maybe let's get a pink color. Oops, saw my custom brush settings there. Get a pink color, press O is for dodge. Seems good, our dodge is working. I is for burn. That's good, burn is working. H is for smudge. So smudge is working too. So okay, so mainly these three. Okay, I'll teach you more of my custom shortcut if I have to. And it didn't really affect too much of the other important shortcuts, so you don't need to worry about that. So even if you're really good in Photoshop already, it does not really mess up your default shortcuts too much. Just making the important things more accessible. So this is very, very important when you're painting and you just want to be fast, right? Everyone wants to be fast and be able to use all these functions very quickly, or personally for me. So dodge, burn, and smudge, okay? So should be able to get that down. Next, we want to just make sure our workspace is correct. So what I see here is our history button. We want to make sure that the problem with the default Photoshop setup is that it's kind of not being utilized for painting. Okay, there's another painting workspace in Photoshop, but I find it quite useless as well. So we set it our own. Okay, do it my way, and then you'll find that it's really useful. Okay, so all these libraries is really redundant, all this space is being really wasted as well. So you want to make sure that you utilize all this space. So if you have a really big computer screen, you can make sure that you use both faces well. Okay, so what I would like to do, okay, we can actually pop them out and put it like this. Okay, so you can click this button and you pop in and out, and then you can set the button like this. And then so here you have the two most useful ones, the layers and the history in a really useful place. So as you do in Photoshop, you have more and more layers, bang, 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 more and more layers. You will be able to have control over all these layers, you know. So you don't need to open up another tab or something. And then same for history, you will be able to undo, do 10 undos in one time with all the history. So these two are the most important for you. And see if I can close this up a bit more. Yep. So you can see, you can customize it quite a bit. So properties and adjustment is used sometimes, but I don't need so much time on actually properties. Yeah. Nah, don't really use it actually. Adjustments. Wait, or do I? Okay, let me see if I. If we do a new adjustment layers, yeah, see, it's just gonna pop up in properties. So this will be used when you do some adjustment layers on top of your layers stuff. Okay, so this is useful to have. And then additional ones that is useful to have, like your character. Okay, so you can just type some text sometimes when you do your other assignments and everything. And let me see which one is useful as well. The tool preset might be useful for you. Like I don't really use it often, but some people use this pretty often, and you will be able to use tool preset. Actions, okay. Actions, I find it very useful. So what I like to do, I always pop it up with my beside my history. So sometimes I'll jump back and forth between actions and history. Okay, teach you guys more about actions next time. So there you go. So we have our Photoshop settings, and this is the workspace we want to be. If you have a big enough monitor, that is. Okay, so you can just shrink the size you want, and then you can save this workspace. Go to workspace and press new, and we will save the workspace. So press new, and new workspace, I'm just gonna lock all this up. So I have keyboard shortcuts, I have menu, I have two bars. So this is just going to make it such that all these positions of your menus, of your buttons and your keyboard shortcuts will be all saved together in the workspace that you have. So this is very good if you are working on your personal computer a lot of times, and then you can just create a workspace here. It's very, very useful. Okay. So maybe I'll just call it your own name. So my name is Alfred. So you correct your own name. What I like to do is also include a date. Okay, today is 27th December. And then your own workspace. Okay. So it makes sense. So you remember exactly when you save it. And if you have a new version, you change the date, etc. And you can also create a version behind it. So if I made another workspace later, I can just version this up, like version 02 behind, right? And then everything will be really neat. Version 1, version 2, version 3. Okay, so this is how you use your naming conventions professionally. Okay, you save it up, and now every time you're just going to jump back to this workspace. And then if I go to, let me see, let's reset essentials. Okay, so this is the default settings again. And now, if you ever go back to default settings, you can just click here, and you go right back to your default workspace. Very, very useful. And if you mess something up, so let's say you make the channels here, and for some reason your layers is here, and your history is here and it's very messy, you can just press workspace, reset workspace, and you'll reset everything. Okay, so pretty useful. Okay, in terms of these settings, this setting works very well if your monitor is quite big. maybe like 20 inch. If your monitor is maybe like 18 inch, 17 inch, very small, what you want to do is you still want to keep the layers and the history tab big, right? But okay, I'm just gonna try to grab these guys out. Oh, it's all stuck together. Okay, so let me drag them out one by one. See how I done that? So I just basically drag the three tabs into here and insert it in between. So the mouse, where you hover it, is very important. See, let me try to do that again. So if you hover over here, the blue color will tell you that you section over here, you insert over here, or you insert below here. So where you put it is very important. So another settings that you can use if your monitor is smaller is kind of like this. So I also use this in class more often because the class monitor is smaller, much smaller, and you want to have a good space of history tabs. And again, cannot stress it enough, the history and the layers are the most important for you, no matter how good you are in painting. Okay, so and you can also change the colors here, so these three will be the most useful. And I like to keep my brushes on the left, so if not, you can just do it on a half screen as well, and it will both be quite useful. And then you can change this, how you view all these brushes as well. Maybe you like to use a large thumbnails, you know, and then you know all the brushes that you're using, or maybe you like to use a stroke thumbnail. See how the stroke comes out for each of these brushes. Okay, or maybe you just want to be same as me. I would want to have a bit of both, so I look at the thumbnails and I look at the name as well. The name for this set of brushes actually makes a lot of sense, so it's kind of useful that way. Alright, so that's it. So you can also save this workspace. So how I would like to do it, I can call this same thing. I'll save all the keyboard shortcuts, menus, and toolbars. I'll put in my own name, the date again, and I'll just say small monitor. Maybe I'll put small monitor in the front so that it's more useful. Okay, so Alfred, small monitor, and then the date, and then the version number. So this is the time when I'm using Photoshop on a small monitor, so I'll use this workspace. Okay, so if I have a big monitor, I'll use the reset this one. Yep. So if I have a small monitor, I'll use this one. If I have a big monitor, I'll use this one. Okay, see how I switch in and forth, switch back and forth, quite easy, very simple. So that's it. I hope you learn how to do this and customize your own workspace, be more professional, and be able to use the workspace to your advantage with all the right settings. Right, see you.